Thank you, Father Becker, Reverend Fathers, our virtuous business leaders, any other honored guests, and finally, my dear brothers. I was born in Lansing, Michigan on October 1st, 1996, but even before my birth, God was already setting his loving plan for my life into motion. I was born as the oldest child in a loving, gigantic Catholic family. My parents raised their children on the strong foundation of their Catholic faith, teaching me principles such as obedience and love for the scriptures. As a young child, I was taught that God loved me. This knowledge of God's love laid a strong foundation for returning that love. To this day, I do not know of any truth more touching than the truth that God loves us. Middle school posed challenges to living out my faith as I began slipping into serious sin and stubborn rebellion. Although I still held to the truths of the faith in my mind, my heart was far from the altar. As high school began, God began changing my heart, planting seeds. I began to desire to know what God had in store for me. I began to desire to be free from my sin. Eventually, I asked several trusted men to pray over me, that I might know the path that God had set out for me. As they prayed, one man spoke up. "Peter, I think there's something in your life that you need to clear out, and then God will make it clear to you what he wants you to do with the rest of your life." These words struck me to the core. At the time, I was still clinging to a lot of my serious sin, and right at that moment, I knew that those sins needed to go. Soon after this experience, God enacted a marvelous change of attitude in me. I got sent to my room one unhappy morning for an ongoing and very serious altercation regarding salmon fishing. I went into that room a beloved, rebellious, miserable wretch of a son. I came out of that room 5 minutes later completely changed. I'm a living testimony to God's power. He transformed my heart in a desperate split-second window of openness. Gradually, the marvelous grace of God began to free me from my sins. I began to reveal my sins more honestly in confession, and I asked a close friend from my small group to hold me accountable to chastity. We called each other regularly to inquire whether we had maintained chastity, as well as to inquire whether we had been faithful to prayer and scripture. By this accountability, we called each other on as brothers to deeper holiness and conversion. We began frequenting weekday mass and confession. Sure enough, the closer I drew to God, the more deeply I felt called to be a priest. After numerous discernment events, and more importantly, after much prayer, I began to set my heart on seminary. At this point, God had given me many signs and had spoken very deeply to me, especially through the scriptures and in the Eucharist. God had called me to seminary, but I didn't have the slightest idea how that was supposed to happen. I was a scared, ignorant 17-year-old, but God was looking into my heart with infinite love and mercy. A great instrument of this love was Father John Linden, the beloved vocations director of Lansing. He guided me through the application process, and God miraculously supplied the funding that allowed me to enter seminary. If I learned one thing from the application process, I learned that God will always provide the grace to follow his call. God never calls us to something without first giving us the grace to succeed. That's a quotation from my bishop. Though I might not have seen how God was going to get me into seminary, he gave me the grace to pursue that call. Since coming to seminary, my life has been completely transformed. Every day, Christ draws me to himself on the cross. He's pouring out his life for the life of the church. He calls me near, that I might pour out my life too. The one who has the bride is the bridegroom. The best man who stands and listens for him rejoices greatly at the bridegroom's voice. So this joy of mine has been made complete. He must increase, I must decrease. As Christ increases and I decrease, my life becomes more of an outpouring for the church. I choose to sacrifice marriage because I have fallen in love with the church, the bride of Christ. As I become Alter Christus, his burning love for his bride consumes me. I can give myself to no one else. Thus I may proclaim with John the Baptist, so this joy of mine has been made complete. This joy stems from Christ's complete gift of self. Christ's gift lives in me. Life's very meaning is found in its seeming demise, complete self-sacrifice. Yet with the author of life, I will offer my life. ever drawing near to that endless fountain of love, ever letting that fountain flow through me in the greatest gift of love I can offer my church, myself. God willing, you will hear me say those blessed words, "This is my body, which will be given up for you." Pray that I may not be a liar when I do so, but that I may be truly conformed to Christ. These words consummate my longing to be another Christ, pouring out his life for his bride, the church. Praise be Jesus Christ.